Hi, it's Frederick again, here for a new episode of What's What. Today, we will talk about blackouts. We are not talking about the crazy nights our parents had in college. We are talking about power outages. A blackout can lead to disaster. Blackouts happen everywhere, all the time. They affect millions of people and can last for hours, days, weeks, even years. With no electricity, we would live in a scary world. So, let's examine the circumstances that lead to blackouts, where they happen, and how they are prevented. If you remember this episode, we briefly went over how the power grid operates and why. But power grids aren't perfect. They can malfunction, just like people. Let's take another look at the power grid. It is divided in four parts: the generation section, the transmission lines, substations and power lines, and section consumption centers like your home or place of work. A disruption of power can occur anywhere, in or between these four sections of the grid. If something happens to a transmission line, for example, it will have a domino effect on the whole grid, where damages to your local power line may only affect a few homeowners. Depending on where disruption occurs, power can go out in the home, your city, region, and sometimes even a whole country. Back in the day, homeowners were connected to a single line of electricity. A failure at any point in the line would cut the consumer from the power source. And just like that, blackout. Then, that poor homeowner would have to wait for an electrician to come, detect the failure, and repair it. Today, electric lines are a bit more advanced. Most transmission lines or paths are connected to a backup line that makes electricity readily available if the active path is disrupted. This is called the N-1 rule. If the demand for electricity is higher, additional backup lines are installed. This is called the N-K rule, with K representing a given number more than one. In a basic sense, the more energy a given consumption location requires, the more lines it will need for backup. This is a foolproof way to ensure that electricity gets to those in need. Still, a lot can go wrong. But speaking of backup, Atina, you there?
What's up, Frederick? I heard you need a help debunking myths about black holes?
No, we are talking about blackouts, like power outages.
In space? Because electricity conducts differently without gravity. There are a lot of blackouts out there.
Well, I thought you came to talk about blackouts here on planet Earth.
Want to see what Earth looks like from the atmosphere?
No.
Yes, you do. Hold on 1 second. Here's the Earth with electricity.
Wow.
I know, right? Cool. Okay, so that should put the power grid into the macrocosm for you YouTubers out there. But with that much electricity traveling through the planet, error is inevitable.
Wait, so you are here to discuss blackouts?
Yeah, Frederic.
But I thought...
I was just messing with you. Vanessa told me you're susceptible at times, so I wanted to test the hypothesis.
She did?
Maybe. Anyway, before we get to power outages, we should actually talk about the different levels of disruptions. For instance, a transient fault, which is when there's a disconnect in the power for a short period of time. Now, correct me if I'm wrong, Frederic, but this usually occurs in power lines.
Yeah, from conductor breaks.
Right, so this type of fault is usually caught by a monitoring system and helps protect the power grid before any damage is done. Next, we have brownouts. And these are actually little shortages in the power grid that lessens the electrical output. So things like your lights can dim, or your internet could get a little bit slower. And lastly, we have blackouts. That is a total loss in power. So there's a complete cut in the current that's transferring from the electric grid to, well, everything that powers your entire house. This can happen from things like natural disasters or tree falling. Now, this actually happened out here in New York City back in 2003. A tree fell in Cleveland of all places, and it created this domino effect, which then created the entire Big Apple to actually lose power. So over 8 states in the United States and Canada were affected. 50 million people for 30 hours experienced blackouts. People actually made the most of it, though. I mean, people were helping each other evacuate the subways. Restaurants gave out free food and beer before it expired. And some even say there was a baby boom.
Ah.
Blackouts can be solved by neighboring grids, which can actually send surplus electricity to help out. For instance, a great way around this is having underground power lines, which helps with the network sensitivity. And what that just means is they don't have to deal with atmospheric disturbances such as snow or meteor strikes. When you're underground, you ain't got that problem.
Not bad, Athena.
Thanks. Just remember, when understanding blackouts, it really is understanding the power grid. Each section relies on one another. It really just comes down to a physics at the end of the day. Energy and electricity, they gotta go somewhere. And you guys have gotta head over to my channel, Astro Athens, to learn more about electricity in space.
I will. Until then.
See ya.
The power grid is susceptible to a variety of hazards, and there are a few internal malfunctions that lead to blackouts as well. First, transmission lines can overheat due to overload. This heat can damage the components of a given transmission line. And too much heat? Another malfunction that can lead to power outage is an imbalance in frequency. Most power grid components operate within a frequency range of 50 or 60 Hz. A constantly changing frequency makes the electricity unstable. If the imbalance is too great, the network collapses. Last, we have synchronism. On an electrical network, the rotors turn at the same speed. This is known as synchronous operation. If the network is desynchronized, you guessed it, blackout. Over the last two decades, billions of hours of electricity have been lost to blackouts, and hundreds of millions of people have been affected. That's why it's important to understand the grid and how it works, so you, electricians of the future, can help to develop safer, more reliable systems to transport electricity.
And watch out for those cyber hackers. They've triggered blackouts in the past. That's no joke.
Athena, you're still here?
I'm always around, like electricity.
Okay, well, that's it for today, everyone. Thanks for watching What's What. Subscribe, leave a comment, maybe even give us a like. You might be shocked at what you learn.